My name is Wenzhuo Wu. I'm an assistant professor here. I started my position here in 3 years ago, in August 2015. So a little bit brief introduction to my background, so you probably will understand what I'm going to talk in the next 5-10 minutes. I'm not a traditional IE background, actually. I was trained as an electrical engineer and a material scientist. I received my PhD in material science from Georgia Tech. Before that, I was a microelectronics major from Singapore and China. So my research here at Purdue IE is mainly focused on nanomanufacturing and advanced manufacturing. So you probably have heard from the previous professor that he mentioned that we have some of the non-traditional disciplines areas here at Purdue IE compared to other programs in the nation. So one of them is the manufacturing. So we have a very strong cohort of faculties on nanomanufacturing using non-traditional processes to tailor the properties of non-traditional materials for some of the very cool, exciting applications. So my group here is mainly focused on three major areas of research targeting nanomanufacturing. So it consists of three pillars. First is materials, second is manufacturing, how we can utilize or develop, either use existing approaches or develop long-existing emerging approaches to process, to integrate, to work on the materials. Then we would like to develop new products to address some of the emerging applications, for example, wearable devices for healthcare monitoring, for human-machine interface, and also some other applications. So this is a very brief snapshot of what we have been doing here. For example, we work on, we have some previous research on nanowires. So these are very tiny nanomaterials. The diameter you're looking here is around tens of nanometers. So 1 nanometer is 10 to the minus 9 meter. Imagine that you have the diameter of the Earth as 1 mile. Then the diameter of a golf ball is 1 nanometer. So that's roughly an estimation between the length scales. Okay, so we can control, we have developed manufacturable scalable approaches to produce these tiny single crystal nanoscale semiconductors, metals, insulators over a very large scale in a very uniform manner. Then we can use them to integrate with the existing microfabrication techniques like the one the industry use to build the chips, the transistors in your cell phone, in your computers, to put those nanomaterials on flexible or stretchable substrate. Then we can develop smart skin devices which can be worn on your body to monitor your motion, to monitor the heartbeat from your body or other physiological signals from your human body. And when I moved to Purdue, Purdue IE has very, very strong faculty research in data science, in production, in optimization, in operational research. So we have been working with some of the colleagues here at Purdue IE utilizing the emerging data approaches like machine learning, artificial intelligence, those approaches, those new frontiers to help us understand better the phenomena at a nanoscale or even atomic scale and how we can control the manufacturing at that small scale. Either we can learn from those data analytics results to better understand some of the previously unknown physics or chemistry at a very small scale, and in a closed loop feedback, we can use those understandings to better guide and control our manufacturing process to enable larger scale production of those small but very powerful materials.